My name is Magnus Mchunguzi. I'm the managing director of Ericsson South Africa. I was born in a place called Bukoba, which is a town in Tanzania. I was born with so much energy, at least when I was young. I used to climb trees, you know, rocks. Every day I came back home, my grandmother had medicine to, you know, tap off my wounds and make sure that they heal. And the next day I'll come back with new wounds. So she called me as a kind of an animal in our village. They call it Katururu, something that is always running around places, and that's what she called me. At the age of 5, I lost my dad. And I do recall the day I had to go wake him up and say to my mother that I don't think he'll wake up again. I didn't know what death was all about. And as a result of it, we had to then leave my grandmother. I used to walk around with a kind of an empty stomach, and you have to learn how to survive. I think what it taught me was how to be a strong person, how to learn to be a real candid guy out there who can fight for myself and hold my own ground. At the age of 9, I moved to live with my uncle in another part of the country called Dar es Salaam. I have to give credit to my auntie and my uncle because at least, you know, they were willing to welcome me into their home, and they're also willing to sacrifice their hard-earned money to put me in school, knowing full well that I was already late in my education. The crucial element was that I knew education would be the only salvation I had. If I did very well in my schools, and ultimately that would be the only way out of the poverty that I was born into. I went to an international school, never have ever spoken a word of English, so that meant that I knew I had another new challenge. You know, it was tough. I had to go to the library, get a dictionary, learn the words, try and figure out what the teachers were talking about. But I knew whatever it took, I'll master the language, I'll be able to speak it, be able to write it, and ultimately it will not be a barrier for my education. And I was the top 3 student when I graduated, which gave me exemptions to go straight to university and do 1 year instead of doing A-level. So I went to Reading University in England, and ultimately I graduated in 1993 with a BSc in Computer Science. But if you look at the period from when I began in 1980 to 1993 in June, it took me almost 12 years to conclude the all school curricula. It doesn't matter when you begin, you can always catch up, you can always push yourself, and it's really, life's not really a sprint, it's more of a marathon, and that everybody who starts late does not have to worry, or if you're born in a disadvantaged environment, doesn't really tell you that that's the end of your road. You can still go out there and fight, and ultimately you could also rise up to the top. What is my vision for my life, my inspiration? That 5 years from now, what I would hope to see, more people participating, we're able to reach a wider part of the continent, able to give more insight into how Africa should be reshaped, then I think I would have done my calling. In life, people talk of luck, but it's always through hard work that you succeed. Don't give up, keep fighting, ensure that you become as good as you can ever be. Don't you